Today marks 1 year since an 18-year-old was shot and killed by an off-duty Davidson County deputy while attending a funeral in High Point. His friends and family came together tonight to celebrate the short life of Fred Cox, Jr. It was held just across the street from the church where this occurred last November. WXI 12's Justin Schreier takes us there.
The celebration of life featured music, dance, prayer, and words of encouragement as community members remembered the life of Fred Cox and continued to push for change.
It's been 1 year since Fred Cox Jr. was shot and killed by an off-duty Davidson County deputy last November. A medical examiner had ruled his death a homicide, but no charges were filed against that deputy. Tanika Shannon, Fred's mother, says the last year has been hard.
Today has been a battle. Knowing that it's been 365 days since we last had Fred here, it's been very difficult. I myself, I'm still trying to define who I am now because my definition is gone.
On Monday night, community members, including Shannon and others, gathered to remember Fred and his celebration of life across the street from the church where that incident unfolded.
He had a free spirit, a giving heart, and he loved people, and people genuinely loved him. So I myself am trying to hold my composure so that his memory can go on with love and laughter instead of pain and sorrow.
Shannon was also joined by other families who had been impacted by gun violence. She says her message to the community is to help keep Fred's name alive.
To help me fight, because it could have been your child.
As she and others push for justice.
We need to stop the cycle now. We don't need another Fred Cox. We need to stop the gun violence, period. Because all lives matter, whether it was police or black-on-black crime. We need to do more by coming together.
And Tanika Shannon tells me that one of her most favorite memories of her son was when she had taken him to the hospital and says Fred saw a man who was brought in by police with no shoes or socks on. She says her son didn't hesitate and gave that man his shoes. She says that gesture speaks to the type of person Fred was. In High Point tonight, Justin Schreier, WXII 12 News.
Justin, thank you. High Point Police are looking